I'm an ex-felon and a recovering addict. I did time. Some people care and some people don't care. But we're all just trying to find our way back home. I'm just a beggar trying to tell other beggars where I found bread.
I'm an ex-felon. I was sent to jail in 2005 for burglary charges. I was addicted to heroin. Some nights I'd go to sleep and I didn't even want to get up. The day you see yourself completely lost in the darkness and don't know where to go, and then you see this light at the end of the tunnel, it's not a train coming to mow you down. It's hope.
We've been sober 35 plus years, and what really pushed us to get sober is we were both addicts, and we got in a big fight one night. I pushed Glenda, who was my girlfriend at that time, up against the wall. She busted her head open, and then I told her, I said, baby, I gotta get right with God.
He said he needed to get back in church, he needed God, and I said, sure, we've done everything else, let's go to church. So we did, and I got saved, and he rededicated his life back to the Lord, and that's how our family began. 12 days later, we got married.
I was terrified when I found out I was going to be a dad because I couldn't hardly take care of us. But when he was born, I remember the first time I held him. You know, it just changed my life. He was my best friend. I'd have him on my shoulders as a kid. We'd be out knocking on doors, telling people how Jesus Christ had changed my life.
My childhood had a lot of church in it. We grew up in the church and actually sang for the church my dad preached at. Got into partying about 16 years old. Was sitting in a car near Fraser with a buddy of mine that I had picked up who said he had pills and he really didn't have pills. And he said, man, it's better than pills, it's cheaper, it'll get you higher. So he tied me off, drew the heroin up in a needle, and he said, just look away. Horrible, sick, powerless feeling that I had, but I was okay being powerless because I was so numb from the heroin. We started stealing stuff from businesses and get that money, and we get more drugs, and we would just continue to do it. And then I remember the first time I withdrawed, I woke up and I was absolute, felt like fire ants were crawling around in my chest. And I said, what's wrong with me? What's happening? He said, we need to get some more heroin. You're going through withdrawals. And from that point on, it wasn't to get high anymore. It was to keep from getting sick.
You know, I knew how I was. I was off the chain. I was shooting up. I went from marijuana to LSD to shooting up to robbing in a real short time. And this was my son that was my best friend. We used to sit up thinking, when they gonna call us? And when they gonna tell us, you know, hey, we found your son, he's dead.
September 18th, 2005. White taxi cab pulled up right next to me underneath this bridge on Crump. Told me to get in, I got in, and he turned around and looked at me from my feet to my head, and he said, I know where you need to go. And I'd heard there was a homeless shelter up there, and that's where I was headed. There was a preacher that was preaching in the other room in the homeless shelter I walked into, and as I walked through this door, his voice got real clear to me, and he was saying, God loves you. He hasn't given up on you. Don't give up on yourself. And he just kept saying that over and over again, and I started crying. I didn't even know I was crying. I think it was my soul. I tell people it was my soul being so tired from me butchering it with needles and drugs that it just said, I give up, I'm done. When I got arrested, it was October 27, 2005, when they sat me down and pulled out all of these charges on paper saying, we know you did this, we know you stole this, we know you did this, hitting their fist on the table, you better tell us what you did. And I said, look, y'all, I'm ready. And I looked at the charges and I admitted to each one that I could remember. And I said, y'all, I was stoned out on heroin. And so they locked me up that night after admitting to everything.
Once you break the law and you're in their hands, you know, they don't know that he's your son, and they don't know what all he's done in his life and what a good kid he is at heart.
I remember calling people, trying to find somebody that could say, hey man, I can relate, or I know a little bit about what you're going through. There wasn't nobody to call.
You know, you're ashamed. You feel like a failure as a dad.
Every pot I'd go to in Memphis and Mississippi, they'd say, who are you with? What gang are you with? And I'd say, I roll with Jesus Christ. That's who I'm with.
About the same time Danny got locked up, I shortly after got hired on as program manager in a prison. We're geared to feast on negativity. You know, there's a lot of negativity in the prison system, but I believe that that can change. CCA does a lot to try to help people, but you gotta want help.
It was in Greenwood, Mississippi that I started really preparing, I think, for freedom. Everybody I've seen, just about I've heard, has come back to prison. And I don't wanna do that. I wanna make a life for myself. My dad's sobriety, watching him not even say anything, just live his life, is inspirational for me. Being a drug and alcohol counselor for countless years now and doing it consistently and successfully, it shows me that I can do it. If my dad could do it, then I can do it. I want to die knowing that nobody knew who I was, but that they can only remember this kid with a tattoo on his neck told him about Jesus. That you don't need drugs, you don't need an excess, tons of alcohol and pornography and whatever else it is that you're struggling with. The cure is in him, and he's real, and he really loves you, and he really cares for you, and he really died for you, and he's really alive, and he's the only one that was ever able to do that. And he gives us for free now this power to live sober. When you've been in the darkness, and you come out of the darkness and you see the light again, believe you me, this is something you want much more than heroin.